All right, so we got a debacle with this unit.
This video is brought to you by Harago.com, a trades-only platform helping you find the right job or the right candidate. Harago.com, best in trade.
Got some sooting here. This was, I think the soot was because this gas valve was only providing 1 inch water column, and it was bumped up to 3, okay? So I think this is from under firing in some previous weeks and months or years. The gas pressure was bumped up, but we found some other things that I don't like here. So the rollout switch in there is supposed to tie into this R1 rollout, and it's supposed to go from basically the power source of W1 through that and into here, but it doesn't. It goes through this centrifugal switch. That red wire comes up, goes through the centrifugal switch and cuts out TH1. It's wired all wrong, so we got to figure this out. And I mean, we have seen better days here. This unit probably should be replaced, but here's the thing. We got to get the heat going for these guys until that can happen. So we're going to try to figure this out. We're going to rewire this unit back to factory wiring, and we're going to test everything again from scratch. So if we look at the diagram here, this is the rollout. That wire basically comes off of this side of this relay, and then it comes down, boom, like this, into there. So here's the wire here coming off that sequencer or relay, right? And if you follow the wire through, we find it, it's capped off. So here's our first problem. Let's rectify this and get it wired right. Okay, so what I'm doing here is I'm changing these, some people call them arret, sometimes wire nuts, depends where you are, but I'm changing them to the male and female connectors, insulated connectors, and just to show you what can go wrong on a job, there's my brand new pack of insulated connectors, and most of them have gone down the duct, and there's some sitting right there. So hey, sometimes things go wrong, but we've got to keep continuing on here, so let's get this done. Okay, so we've redone these, we've zip tied everything all nice and neat. Okay, and just so you guys know, there's two limits in here. One is a manual reset. The one on the left has got a button on the top, and the other one is an automatic reset. So it's got two limits for redundancy, and they're set at different temperatures. So let's get back to the front of the unit. We're gonna put the lid back on and we'll wire in the rest of it. Fire this thing up. Okay, so we're all wired up as neat as possible, I guess, as we can get. And most of the terminals I replaced on this, except for this one, because it was pretty new, because this motor is pretty new itself. So it's got to maybe add a couple more zip ties to get these wires all nice and tight, but we're pretty much ready to fire up. This insulation here, like I said, this unit needs to be taken off the roof and needs to be replaced, but we're going to try to get them heat for as long as we can until we get a replacement done on this machine. Let's fire it up. I'm gonna stick my manometer on it again just to make sure our gas pressure is good. Okay, so I ended up changing the ignition module. I'll tell you why, because I cycled this thing about 10 times. One time it didn't start. That's enough for me. If it's not gonna start that one time, and the module had power, I'm like, okay, that old module maybe intermittently causing an issue. It's getting out of here, so we changed it. Sometimes I was only getting the flame coming across halfway, three quarters. Sometimes it would come across the whole way, but I didn't like the intermittent way it was coming across this tubing. So I'm gonna change this tubing right now. I have a brand new one right here. We're gonna get this new one in, and then we're gonna test everything again. Okay, it's all up and running now. All right, I did check the gas pressure, and sorry I didn't take any footage of it, but I mean, I've just been doing a lot of stuff here, trying to get on the road here so I can get home. The gas pressure is at 3.5, where it should be, and we're running kind of nice. We got a nice flame there. Okay,
some wind flopping it around a little bit, but everything's all fixed up and we're ready to rock. So
happy HVACing.